Now, we come to the second chapter of the Natyashastra, which is dedicated to creation of a theater house. But before I proceed to give you an account of what is the second chapter and how does it describe the ancient theater house, how does it tell us about the creation of the theater house and later on responsibility of various people in maintaining the theater house during the performance. Before I do that, let me also give you an account of what are the contents of Natya Shastra. You see, Natya Veda is the system of knowledge that you get by seeing this particular art form, theater. The knowledge that you get in theater is Natya Veda. And the method by which theatrical performances are to be created and performed is the Natya Shastra. See, there will always be a confusion in the minds of some people, many people, regarding the difference between Natya Veda and Natya Shastra. Is Natya Shastra the same as Natya Veda? Or is Natya Veda different from Natya Shastra? Who created Natya Veda? Bharat Muni did not create Natya Veda. It is Brahma who created Natya Veda, the system of knowledge. But Brahma did not create Natya Shastra. You see, Natya Shastra was created or compiled or collected by Bharat Muni. Now, here it's important to understand that the essential knowledge of the Vedas was made into the fifth Veda, but in order to communicate that, you need an art form. In order to govern that art form, to teach it to people, to use it for the purpose of entertainment and education of people, you need a certain discipline. Shasanopayam, an upaya, an instrument of shasan. Shasan here does not mean, government administration. But here it means the discipline which is academic. Discipline which is in the study and in the practical method of use of the art of drama. So that is Natya Shastra. And that is the difference between Natya Veda and Natya Shastra. Natya Shastra is about the practical methodology of producing a play. And Natya Veda is the knowledge that is contained in the art of drama.